Just this afternoon, the total is about $14 million. That's the cost incurred by communities across the state to stage two elections this year that weren't in the budget. And those costs are being picked up by local taxpayers.
Two unplanned elections, the statewide recall and the primary that led up to it, took a financial toll on local communities across the state.
We are probably looking at an excess of $26,000 for June's election and about $15,000 for the May primary.
Franklin City Clerk Sandy Wesolowski says that the recalls created more elections with more poll workers and more election materials than the city had budgeted for.
What was the impact of the recalls?
I hate to use the word overwhelming, but it all happened so fast you really didn't have time to be overwhelmed by it.
Here's how the costs break down statewide. $6.3 million for the May primary and $7.2 million for the June recall election. A total of $13.5 million to local municipalities and their taxpayers. And another $663,000 incurred by the state's Government Accountability Board. Leaving one important question for taxpayers and voters. In the end, was it worth it?
I believe it was worth it. I believe it was worth it if you're looking at a defense of democracy.
It probably wasn't worth that amount of money. It may not have been worth any amount of money to go through all that trouble.
And on that question, voters seem to remain as divided as they were before the recall.
Is this a democracy? If it's a democracy, then yes, it was worth it.
All it did was cost the people of Wisconsin millions of dollars for nothing.
Meanwhile, for local election officials, there is now something else to consider at budget time.
Next year, hopefully, we will budget for two elections, and maybe that's all we'll have.
United Wisconsin, the group that launched the recalls, did not return our calls today. The state Democratic Party had no comment on the cost numbers, but the Republican leader in the assembly, Robin Voss of Racine County, called the price tag an outrage. He said he will introduce legislation to make it harder to initiate a recall election in this state. So a remarkable day, all of this happening late this afternoon. We're going to wait to see how this all plays out with the judge's ruling coming down today on Act 10.